One of four top 25 matchups in the FCS this week will be Saturday afternoon in Cedar Falls, Iowa, as number 2 South Dakota State visits 25th ranked Northern Iowa. Hi, friends, and welcome to Game Day Eve here on GoJacks.com. I'm Tyler Merriam as we talk about tomorrow afternoon's showdown in the Unidome between the Jackrabbits and the Panthers. Well, SDSU certainly had a very successful Hobo Day, beating Youngstown State by a final of 36-7. Have to give the defense a lot of credit after allowing 148 yards in the opening quarter. The Jacks limit the Penguins to only 196 over the last three periods of play. Tevin McCaster, the All-American tailback, ran for 27 yards on his first touch. He ends up with only 60 total rushing yards on 22 attempts. The Jacks had two interceptions, a couple of sacks, eight tackles for loss. Defense really played well. And C.J. Wilson had to step in for the injured Isaac Wallace. The senior's career came to an end on a freak play in the first half. Wilson steps in at tailback, rushes for 119 yards and a score on 16 carries. Great effort by the freshman on Saturday. So the Jackrabbits enter this one with a mark of 4-1, 2-1 in the Valley. Northern Iowa is also 2-1 in Missouri Valley Football Conference play. The difference, the Jacks' two wins have come at home, UNI's two on the road. They shut out Indiana State a few weeks back, and then on Saturday, a 42-28 win at the University of South Dakota. Game was tied at 21. Panthers scored 21 straight. The big story in that game for UNI, defensive turnovers. They forced three that led to 21 points, as that was really the undoing for South Dakota. The Coyotes enter this matchup with some revenge in mind, no doubt. It was SDSU who eliminated UNI from the playoffs a year ago, 37-22, limiting the Panthers to fewer than 100 rushing yards. That was after last Hobo Day, of which UNI ruined homecoming for South Dakota State on that rainy day, a 38-18 Panther win. So the two teams split the matchups a season ago, the Jacks winning the one in the postseason. I mentioned the UNI defense. It's led by Ricky Neal up front. He is as talented of a defensive end as you will see in this Missouri Valley Football Conference. Neal against the Coyotes had six tackles, three for loss, two sacks, and a forced fumble. Preseason All-American, who a year ago led the Valley with 9.5 sacks. Should also talk about Chris Kolarvik. He is a redshirt freshman linebacker from the state of Michigan who is third in the Valley in tackles with 65. That's Mark Farley's defense. They're always athletic. They'll throw different wrinkles at you. They busted out a 3-3-5 a week ago against USD. On the offensive side, it is led by the gunslinger from Grinnell, Iowa, Eli Dunn. And he is a veteran making his 22nd career start. The 6'5 senior a week ago was Valley Offensive Player of the Week. In Vermilion, he completed 24 of 33 passes for 257 yards and four touchdowns. He hit eight different receivers in the process. They'll use two different running backs. They operate in much different ways, but they're both very successful. Marcus Weimiller, who really is that physical interior runner who will run right through you. He had the huge day on Hobo Day last year against South Dakota State. Then they'll mix in Trevor Allen, who ran for 180 yards and two scores in the victory at Indiana State a couple of weeks ago. Again, two different backs, but very successful. And they have the honorable mention All-Valley tight end from a year ago in Briley Moore. He already has 23 catches, averaging almost 14 yards per grab. UNI will use its tight ends as well as any team in the FCS. One other note about the Panthers that is worth recognizing, they are one of four teams in the nation perfect inside the red zone. 22 times they have invaded the opponent's 20-yard line, and each of those 22 occasions they have come out with a score. So it's a big one on Saturday in the Unidome as South Dakota State takes on Northern Iowa. The other oddity about this matchup, you throw out the playoff win by SDSU here at Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium last December. The previous four meetings in the regular season between these two teams have all been won by the road team. South Dakota State will look to repeat that on Saturday afternoon. It will be homecoming for UNI. The Panthers are ranked number 25 in the nation. Again, they're 2-1 in the Valley, just like SDSU. The second-ranked Jacks are 4-1 overall, UNI 3-3. Kickoff will be at 4 o'clock. This is the Missouri Valley Football Conference game of the week, so the telecast is free on ESPN3.com. Or you can join us on the Jackrabbit Sports Network. Alex Parker, Scotty Quaz, and myself will start our coverage at 3 o'clock as number 2 SDSU visits number 25 Northern Iowa tomorrow afternoon inside the Unidome in Cedar Falls.